Welcome to the AMA that BitHump is hosting on the Telegram together with VirusCoin. Mike Tony, the lead developer of VirusCoin, is answering questions. Five questions have been pre-selected, and after he answered those, he will answer questions from the rest of the community. The first question is asked is, why is Virus different from other blockchain protocols? Michael answers as follows. Virus has a number of capabilities that make it unique across all other blockchain protocols. A, Virus is the first and only blockchain network to offer 100% self-sovereign, friendly name, recoverable, revocable, transferable, and multi-sig identities. IDs can be used to receive funds, prove your identity cryptographically, digitally sign messages, content, and files of any type. And in case you lose your identity keys, you can actually revoke and recover your identity without losing funds. Identities are also transferable to others, along with all of their funds. So they can be used by businesses and organizations as well. B. Virus supports zero-knowledge privacy with a technology known as zk-SNARKs, first made popular by Zcash and greatly simplified by user, simplified for user by supporting private transactions and private encrypted messaging using friendly name identities. Virus is the only protocol that offers zero-knowledge privacy with friendly, easy-to-use names. C. Virus combines mining and staking in its consensus algorithms and can still be mined by PCs almost as well as an FPGA due to the unique Virus hash, quantum resistant hash algorithm. This is all combined in a 51% hash attack resistant protocol called Proof of Power. To mount a 51% hash attack on Virus, an attack must secure a total of 51% of all validated power, including mining hash and staking power combined. D. The upcoming Virus release, which has been running smoothly on the Virus testnet for months, includes an advanced network-wide DeFi protocol and the ability to time lock an ID, enabling its owners to use funds for staking while preventing virtually all forms of funds or identity theft. Question 2. Why do I want a Virus ID? What can I use it for? And Mike answers, Virus IDs are owned permanently and can be transferred just like cryptocurrency. There are no annual fees, and the fees required to purchase a Virus ID go to miners, stakers, and referrers only. A Virus ID can immediately be used as a friendly name crypto address that is controlled by one or more crypto addresses, meaning it can be even multi-sig. And they offer the unique ability to be of being revocable and recoverable. That means if you lose the key to your controlling addresses of a Virus ID, you do not have to lose the ID or the funds under its control. Virus ID even provides a permanently owned digital signature, which can be used to securely sign messages, files, and other content, and is managed and changed as needed by the owner, no one else. Virus IDs can be created using any character set worldwide and can be easily validated worldwide as well. Finally, Virus IDs form the foundation for Virus DeFi currency definition, application data types in the soon-to-be-released Virus Data Exchange Format, VDXF, and content for user profiles. And
what language can people code in when writing applications for Virus? Can people port whole projects over from ETH and other protocols? How does that actually work?
Mike answers. The Virus community believes that it's time for a new paradigm in decentralized applications, one focused on data and interoperability. Much like the open web, not any specific language or execution environment, such as the Ethereum virtual machine. Right now, arguably the most popular application to use blockchain and cryptocurrency today, Brave, is written in C, C++,
and JavaScript, with Ethereum providing basic cryptocurrency functionality only that is used by the rest of the system. Verus DeFi and the Ethereum Bridge, which will soon be on mainnet, provides core cryptocurrency functionality without any programming at all. Identity and DeFi capabilities that can be used across many decentralized or centralized applications written in just about any language. Once the Verus Ethereum Bridge, which we are working towards releasing within the next month, is available on mainnet, even applications that want to leverage some capabilities in the Solidity virtual machine, which we believe will be largely unnecessary, can do so if they choose. In lieu of the specific programming language, the Verus project offers core identity, cryptographic and currency related capabilities, and the VDXF, or Verus Data Exchange Format, a model for all applications to define such data structures and data interchange rules, which can be used either by any language, either through on-chain transactions or off-chain to provide data interoperability between decentralized and centralized applications. Any language will be possible to integrate with the Verus blockchain and other applications using the VDXF. Specifications and applications that leverage the VDXF are in development in the community and will be broadly available when Verus DeFi and the Ethereum Bridge are released to mainnet. Question 4. What motivated the Verus focus on equity, truth, and privacy? When the Verus founders, a number of people, including myself, who felt that crypto projects were becoming too focused on getting rich quickly and had lost the vision of improving society through decentralized technologies, connected with Komodo and his lead developer JL77, we decided to collaborate from various parts of the world to leverage Bitcoin, Zcash, and KMD open source technology as a foundation to create the next generation in blockchain evolution. The result was the Verus project, a fully open, decentralized community effort with no ICO, no pre-mine, no development fee, and no rent seeking at all, funded by donations, offering a platform for people, businesses, organizations, and governments, open to all as a core platform to improve and build upon together, with a philosophy where each community member or organization can be part of a much larger, worldwide, rent-free, decentralized system, much more like the internet of a blockchain than a corporation on its own. Improvement and built through cooperation and collaboration, not centralized control. A last question. Verus uses ZK snarks like Zcash. Is Verus a privacy coin? And Mike answers, Veruscoin, the currency used to secure the Verus network through staking, and which is an integral part of the new Verus DeFi system, supports fully private, zero-knowledge transactions that use the Zcash-compatible Zk-Snark technologies. While that does qualify Verus to be a privacy coin, the smart transaction support, Verus ID, and Verus Data Exchange Format, as well as the vision of using zero-knowledge capabilities for voting, private messaging, and privacy-respecting applications, make Verus not only a privacy coin, but an entire privacy-respecting protocol and application-enabling platform. Okay, this concludes the end of the pre-selected questions. Mike starts answering questions that are asked in the meantime in Telegram. Kim AI asks, big problem for a lot of DeFi projects seems to be that when farming starts, the price goes down because people unload to put liquidity into a farm. Will there be an incentive to hold and not just farm and dump? Mike answers, Verus DeFi is unique in that its technology is the only DeFi technology actually built into the core of the blockchain platform. It is also the only UTXO-based DeFi technology we know of, enabling it to process and simultaneously solve all DeFi conversions relating to any DeFi or basket currency that occur within one block, making it very resistant to front running and enabling everyone converting in all directions to get exactly the same price, no spread. All DeFi currencies include Verus, as Verus is required to pay mining and staking fees, as well as used as a core currency across the platform. That means that if you use Verus DeFi to convert from ETH to DAI or USDT, for example, the necessary fees to pay miners or stakers will automatically be converted to Verus and paid as part of the mining staking fees, as well as the other part going into the actual DeFi currency itself. Verus inside of a DeFi currency or basket cannot stake to secure the Verus network, so everyone will need to decide which is more important to them, including Verus in a DeFi currency to achieve some yield, or keeping it standalone to earn network staking rewards. In many ways, unlike Ethereum, Verus is well integrated into the entire platform in an elegant design that we believe ensures Verus will always reflect the value of the entire usage of this advanced new DeFi system. Aurelia asks, how will you prevent copies of tokens from being included for the purpose of defrauding users? Do you have a system to remove these tokens from the pool? Mike answers, we have already solved the uniqueness problem through Verus ID, and the only currencies that can be created or used on the Verus system will either be created through a unique ID on the Verus network or from external Verus ETA bridges or bridges to other blockchain platforms or systems. Preventing copies and validating currencies was one of the reasons we created the Verus ID system before completing Verus DeFi and preparing it for mainnet, even though we have been testing it for over 1 year. Linda Elizabeth asks, what exactly is impermanent loss? How does a liquidity provider encounter impermanent loss? What are the major factors that can influence the impermanent loss that a liquidity provider may? Mike answers, impermanent loss is a poorly understood aspect of DeFi or basket currencies that is only affected when comparing the relative performance of holding a static set of assets versus a yield-producing basket of currencies. It can only be considered when comparing between these two modes of investment, not as an actual issue by itself in absolute sense. Today, the solutions to impermanent loss on other projects are either to charge higher fees to provide more yield at the expense of lower user adoption, or to bind initial entry to specific currencies and adjust relative percentages ratios to reserves in the basket. Although the Verus DeFi algorithms can be easily adapted to either of these solutions, we believe both approaches are flawed. It is important to understand that yield in any DeFi pool is a function of the pool market cap, the total transaction volume over a period of time, and the fees. Verus fees are very low, from 0.025% to 0.05%, divided between network miners and stakers and DeFi currency holders, liquidity providers. At the same time, the simultaneous solving of all transactions in all directions means that large transaction volumes can be handled much more stably on lower market caps than what is possible in serialized Ethereum, EOS, or other solutions available today. That means that a smaller market cap can handle larger transaction volumes, offering holders a greater opportunity for yield without raising fees for users. We believe that in this sense, liquidity providers or holders will seek yields that reflect an expected counter to any relative risk of impermanent loss, and that adjusting reserve ratios of individual currencies is simply unnecessary and adds complexity in every aspect. For example, the more transactions that go over any DeFi currency in a Verus system, the more stable it becomes, whereas the opposite is true for DeFi systems in use today. Aurelia asks, do you have any reward program event ongoing or upcoming Please give us details. And do you have any ambassador program also? Many communities organize events for attract more people. It is also main thing for attract investors. Mike answers, we have always, since the beginning, been a community-driven, donation-funded worldwide project. For example, when Bithumb recognized the value of the Verus network and offered free listing if we would provide $50,000 that would go back to all people using their exchange in the form of competition prizes, that was raised across the worldwide community in a matter of days without any problem. There is also the Verus Coin Foundation, which was funded by donations and provided ongoing bounties for contributors across the worldwide community in order to support the project's growth and success. All core members have either been part of founding or joining the project because we believe 100% in what the project can do for everyone, from individuals to companies to governments. We are always looking for strong contributors to the project in all areas, from development to communications and everything in between. If you are interested in contributing and believe you have the skills or ideas, please join our Discord. You will find that a growing community is friendly and always interested in new contributors. Opportunities range from core community contribution to companies looking for more people to help them build on Verus. CryptoTrader asks, what directions of Verus development, in your opinion, will be the most attractive for large organizations and institutional finance? What are the main use cases for VRC tokens on the Verus platform? Which of all these use cases, in your opinion, is the most important for the adoption of DeFi? And Mike answers, we are already growing, but when we release the Ethereum Bridge, it will be very easy to both create and fund new projects on the blockchain using Verus that can easily be ERC20 tokens as well, with no program required. We also believe we have the best DeFi technology in existence, and that when it goes live, people will want to secure their funds now on Ethereum using the Verus ID technology, as well as achieve better currency conversions through sending their ERC20 tokens and other currencies to Verus from Ethereum. In some ways, you might think of Verus as a much more complete DeFi system, ID system and currency or project launch system than anything on Ethereum today, although it is really so much more. As far as other projects competing, they are welcome to try to do so. But that is one reason why we believe that by having no company, no rent, no front running, the best free structure for users and a platform that can host an unlimited number of independent projects, either through currencies on the Verus main blockchain or with PBAS on their own independent interoperable blockchain. We are building an internet of blockchains that will serve all projects and organizations wanting to use these technologies, and together we will build a network bigger than any single project. In summary, we believe that with our model, it is better to join and contribute to solutions than for anyone to compete. We will see over time, but this is what we believe. And this concludes the AMA of Verus together with Bithumb. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. I'm Oink, and I hope to see you in our community. Goodbye.